Hi guys, it's Katie here again from Bella Creativa, and I'm doing the second part, I guess you could say, of a not tutorial where I'm using some of the templates and SVG files to make a little travel folio thing. So I thought I would just keep going with my not tutorial and show you what I've done. I've also got a couple of little freebies that I'm going to put in the Facebook group, so I'm going to use those, so and I'll show you, and then you know you can pick them up in the Facebook group, which is Bella Creativa Divas. I'll put the link in the description box below. Anyway, if this is the first time you've been here, this is part two of a not tutorial, so you might want to go and find the actual tutorial for making something similar to this. So I'll try and remember to link that one for you as well. Otherwise, this is me just crafting with the camera on. In fact, it's 3:30 in the morning and I can't sleep. So I have a cup of tea and I'm just going to craft and have my cup of tea. And I'm sure I'm not the only person who's crafting at 3:30 in the morning. I'll just have a sip. Okay. So in the last video, we used the file folder templates, these ones here, and I just used them in a slightly different way to make quite a simple structure. So rather than looking for like a file folder, we covered it with this faux leather, which I love. And then I've just done a really simple insert page, no fancy flips or anything this time, just something quite plain. So I'm going to put some bits and pieces in here today. So we don't need this for the moment. I don't really need this for the moment. I have lots of little inserts and bits and pieces here that I've cut out already. So what have I cut out already? Oh, well, let's start with this. It's a journal. This is going to be my journal that's going to slot into the middle, and I haven't really cut anything special out for this one. So this is just a piece of cardstock, letter sized, and I think I've trimmed a little bit off the top so that it would fit in my little folio. And the only thing that I have done since the last video is put some eyelets in the top and bottom of the spine here so that I can tie my journal in. So I wanted to make sure that this was smaller than the space between my eyelets. So I've trimmed this down to 20 centimeters, or just a little bit less than 8 inches. And then I think it was just a letter sized piece of cardstock folded in half. I don't think I trimmed anything off this side, so it's 5.5 inches or 14 centimeters. So that is just gonna fit in here. And so then I've just chosen some random bits of paper here that I'm going to put in as my signature. So I've just got a piece of the scrapbook paper, some pinola roll, coffee stone paper, just some plain copier paper, but it's like a creamy colour, some music paper, a bit of greaseproof paper. This paper here is calligraphy paper, so it's for practicing calligraphy writing, you know, so it's on the slant so that you slant your letters properly. And then there's some more copy paper, some book page, and just a few bits. Just it's all quite plain because I want to be able to, you know, provide lots of writing space. So that's just going to go in here, like so. So all I have to do is trim it to fit, which I probably could have done before I started the camera, but I'm just going to find found a pencil and just line up my pages and draw a line down here and a line across here, and that's where I'm going to trim, maybe just a touch inside those two lines. So what do I do with my bulldog clip? There it is. So now I'll just trim that along there and I'll be back. Okay, so I've just trimmed down my signature and now I'm just going to pop it in my cover and find the center page somewhere. Okay. And I might use, I guess I'll just go with this again. Just going to hold that in. And then I'm just going to, do a three-hole pamphlet stitch to hold my little signature in place. There is quite a few pages, so I wouldn't try and put this through my sewing machine. I'd never have much luck with that anyway. So I've got three little places to put the hole, and so I don't know what I've done to my awl because it's a little bit bent on the end, but I'm just going to shove it through. Try not to take out my own finger or something. Okay, and then down here, quite a lot of pages to shove through. And the same up here. There we go. All good. And then I had, what did I do with it? Oh, here it is. Okay, so I've got some embroidery thread that I have put on here, and I've already put the needle on the end even. Look at me go. And I'm just going to make sure we've got enough. Trim that off. Oops, scissors do not want to do that. Okay. So if you start your three-hole pamphlet stitch on the inside of your book, you will finish with the strings on the inside of the book. So that's what I think I want to do. So I'm just going to go from the middle to the bottom or the top, who cares, doesn't matter. I don't even know which way is the right way around at the moment, doesn't matter. Bring it through there and then to the top. I mean, you've probably seen me do this before, or you've seen somebody do it before, because I'm pretty sure this is how most people do their signatures. And you could definitely do a fancier one, but this is just a little signature journal, so it doesn't seem really worth it to do anything fancy. Now I'm just trying to get this back in here. Doesn't want to play along. Whoops. I mean, we've already been through this hole, so I don't know why we're being so difficult about it. There we go. Alright, I'm going to pass that through there. I'm going to pass it back that way. There we go. And then put my needle over there. I can lose that one later. Spend forever looking for it. Just going to tie these up. I don't know, is there a fancy knot? I would call it a granny knot. Like so. And that is our book, our journal done. And oh, look at that, I got it the right way up. Brilliant. So So I've already rounded the corners on here, so I will go ahead and round the corners of all my little pages as well, but I won't bore you with that. And then I've just cut some of my paper that I'm using. So I've got this scrapbook paper, which is very readily available in Australia and has been for at least a few years now. This papercraft one. It's a good basic sort of vintage background paper scrapbook pad, I think. So I'm going to, I've already cut these out to fit just to save a bit of time. So I'm thinking this one will go on here. And so I just have to glue that on. It's not very exciting. I still feel like I might want something else on here, maybe layer something else up, but I don't know what. And that's a big decision to make at whatever time it is now. What time is it now? It is 3:52 a.m. I don't think I want to make decisions about embellishments when I haven't had enough sleep. So what happens is my partner works shifts, so he finished at midnight and he got home about 12:30, and I was asleep until he got home. But our dogs go mental as soon as he gets home, barking like maniacs. I mean, they're doing their job, aren't they? They're being good little guard dogs. But there's no way you could sleep through it. And then so it wakes me up and then I just cannot get back to sleep. And I'm looking for my blindfold. Yeah, so I went back to bed and I put my iPods in and you know, tried to listen to a podcast, and sometimes that's good for helping me get to sleep. No, not today. I've listened to about 3 podcasts and I did not fall asleep. And I was laying in bed thinking, oh, I really want to finish off that project that I started, the not tutorial project, this one. And I thought, oh, well, I'll get up and do it. So here we are. So just put that one together. Need a little bit more glue under there. Bit miserly with the glue. And then you do a bit too much of the glue. You know how it is. Okay, so then I have also cut some pages for the inside, which is going to go here. And then thoughts. I've got this little guy here, which I'll tell you about in a minute. I'm just trying to decide whether I put him in there. Yeah, I'll put him there. Okay, so I'll put this on as well. So I've got in that little bundle of goodies there, some things that I've cut out of the journal pack. And one of those is that slot pocket there. So I'll show you what I've cut out. So in my little one signature journal here, I was not thinking about putting too many pockets in. In fact, I haven't cut out any pockets for it yet, because it's going inside my folio that has got pockets already. So I'm sort of thinking I might not need pockets in my journal as well, but I can always go back and cut out some of the pockets out of the journal pack. And they should fit in here. But we'll see, because, you know, every time you cut out and put a pocket in, you have to put something in it, right? And I find it really difficult to put less than 3 things in a pocket because I just like the layering. But boy, does that, that can be quite difficult trying to find three interesting things to go in a pocket, especially if you're just putting millions of pockets in there. I mean, there's only so many tags you need, right? Okay, looking cute, so I'm just going to do those little corners, but I'll do them off camera. So yes, I cut some things out of the journal. So this is the journal pack. So this is a set of SVG files and printable templates, and these are just little things that you can use to, you know, make journals. So one of the things here is my slot pocket, so I've cut that out, and this is going to go in my journal. So I've cut the blue bit out underneath out of the cardstock, and then the pink piece on top I've cut out of my scrapbook paper. Now, because this is not a journal, I haven't gone into all the details, but I have done videos before on how I've used the journal pack, so I will try and remember to link them here. I'll put them in the description box, or if I can, I'll put one of those little cards up the top so that you can go and check out some of the other videos where I have done a bit more of a tutorial on how to use these files. But this, as I say, is not a tutorial. I would not be trying to do a tutorial at 4 a.m. So I was yesterday working on a sort of a some files to make a Christmas album. Last year I did a December daily, and it was pretty wild, and there was lots of files, and it kind of killed me. So this year I'm doing something far more simple. I'm just going to do a really cute album, I think. Really plain and sweet little album. That's my plan. We'll see. But I did start working on that. Okay, so I put that on, and then I'm going to put it on here. And I'm going to use my stronger glue, and I'm going to make it so each pocket is progressively longer, so I'm just going to glue around the edges basically. Alright, so I'm just going to glue around here and down here and along the bottom. I might just put a little bit more glue up the top there so that things don't get trapped under theirs, which can sometimes happen. And then I'm just going to pop this down. I'm going to put it a little bit further towards the bottom than the top so things can have got room to poke out about there. Just press that down. And voila, we have a little spot in the inside cover for little bits and pieces. All right, so that's that one. I'm going to put that on the, that just dropped on the floor was a needle. I'll probably never find it again. Okay, so there's my journal. Then I have a little bunch of other things here. Hang on, I'm just going to see if I can find that needle before someone stands on it and finds it. Got it. All right. Put this in a safe place. Oh, I can't reach my safe place. All right, I'm just going to put it over here. Okay. All right. So now I've cut a few other things out of the journal pack that I thought I might put in. Just stick in the pages, basically. So I've cut out one of the little viewfinders. Now, I have not cut out the bit underneath it. I've just cut out the viewfinder. I think I'm just going to pop it in like that because that's just kind of fun on its own. And then I have also cut out one of the Rolodex cards down here. I don't think I've cut out a mat for it. I think I've just cut it out like that. So I might stick that in a pocket. I have cut out some of the tickets, and I had already gone ahead and cut out the little pink mats that go on there, and I just did some stamping on them, and that was fun. So they're all ready to go in a pocket. And then I've got, so these were the bits of paper that I think I might have showed you in the last not tutorial video, that I was trying to find the right paper to match the inside of my folio, this colour one here. And so I printed a whole bunch out, but they're all in the same sort of tones. So I have cut some bits and pieces out with these. So this piece here, which is just a piece of copy paper that I've printed on, I have cut out the large bag. So I'm going to make the large bag out of that one. Then the small bag I've cut out here, as you can see. That's the small bag. I've cut that one out. Then I have cut out a library pocket here, but I haven't cut the mats. I think I'm just going to leave it plain. So I might do that. I've also cut out one of the CD sleeve pockets here, but I haven't cut out the bit that goes in the middle. I'm just going to use a bit of greaseproof paper, coffee stain or vellum or something like that. So I can put those things together. And what else did I cut out? Okay, this one here is the notebook insert. So I think I made it a little bit smaller so that I knew that it would fit in my pocket, this notebook insert. So it's got these little holes down the side and then the little mat fits on top. So it actually comes in the fold in the SVG file bigger than this, but I sized it down because I wanted to make sure it fit in my pocket okay. So that's just like a little insert that I can pop in there. Just need to put the mat on that one. And then, sip of my tea. Good, good. And then I have cut out the file folder here, which I also shrunk down a little bit because I want to make sure it fits in my file folder. But that's the beauty of these SVGs. Look at that. I can make it whatever size I like. And then I also cut out two of the corner pockets so that when I open up my file folder, I can have two little corner pockets, one on each side down here like this, and one on this side down here like this. And then I've also cut mats out for everything, for the pockets, the little pink bits on top. I've cut those out. And then for the actual file folder itself, I've cut out the mats for the inside and the outside, and also the little groovy bits that go on like that. So that's all ready to stick on. And I'll go off and do that and come back. And then I just cut out a few of the little page tabs. Not quite sure where I'm going to put them, but they're there if I want them. So I just got some of those little page tabs down there, all ready to go. What for? I don't know. And then, oh, they're the newbies. So I tell you what, I'll go away and do this and this, and then I'll come back and we'll do this together maybe. Yeah? Okay, so I'll see you in a minute. I'll finish my cup of tea. I'll see you soon. Okay, so I went ahead and put all of those mats on here and put the little pockets in there, and I'll probably do some embellishment of some type on the cover, but I'm not sure what yet. So I tend to this is how I work anyway. I just do everything step by step. I don't, yeah, everyone works differently. And then in here, I've just attached that mat to this cute little insert. This would be a great place to weave a little bit of ribbon or something in. And then I've just popped that roller decks in there for the moment. I've just attached those little page bits so that I don't lose them. And the same with these guys here. I've just tucked them in here for now. And then I did go ahead and round the edges of my little journal. So that is all done now. And I'm just holding it close with this little bulldog clip. So then we've got a few more little bits and pieces to do. So this is from the journal pack. This is the little coin bag. I'll just grab that again. Okay, this is the little small bag. So all we need to do is just add a little bit of glue to this one. This was a really good way to use up the bits of paper that I printed out and then decided that I didn't want to use for in the actual book itself. So put some glue on there, and then that's one little thing done. We can put something in there or poke something out. Cute. Then this is the library pocket, and I might actually put that in the journal somewhere. So I'm just going to glue these little tabs down. This is just copy paper, so I want to put that there. I'm not thinking very well today. Must be because it's, you know, 4:30 now, I think. No, it's not even 4:30. Anyway, I think today is going to be a tricky day. I'm going to fold that over there. Now, I could have put a mat on here because there is a mat here, but I'm not going to. I'm just living on the edge. I think it's okay, you know. Okay, so that one's ready to go. And then this little guy here, I meant to get a bit of paper to... 1 minute. Okay, I'm back. I've got this greaseproof paper here that's been coffee stained. And I'm just... So I could have cut that mat out, but I'm being extraordinarily lazy. And I'm just going to roughly cut it to fit, and it'll be fine. So I need to cut from there and along there. You won't see it. It'll be okay. And then I'm just going to trim along there. And let's make sure it fits, shall we? I could probably trim a little bit more off here. Whoops. And that'll do the trick. So then I'm gonna put some glue around here. Whee! Small things. And then some glue around here. And pop that little guy down there. Looks like it hangs over just a little titch there, so let's just give that a little trim. Okay, good now. Good now. A little press. You might have noticed that when I do tutorials, I'm I'm a little more precious about how I put it together. Okay, and then we're just going to put some glue on these tabs here. Once again, I'm just using this glue because it's just copier paper. It's not anything too heavy and thick. So this should do the job, I think. Fold that over. Try and line it up. Get my gluey fingers off. Give it a press. Right, so this little tab here is in case you wanted to attach this to your page with that little tab, and then you could attach it to the side of your page, and then you could flip it out if you want to. I don't know if I want to use it like that yet or not, so I'm just going to leave it on. But here we do have a little CD pocket. How cute is that? So then we can dress that up somehow, put a little insert in it. I'm not quite sure what to do, so for now I'm just going to pop it in a pocket. I might just pop it in this pocket for now. Just something a little bit interesting and different. These two, I'm going to pop this in a pocket. Pop it in a pocket. Pop it in this one. And this one I'm going to put in my journal, but I'm not quite sure where. So I'm just going to slide it under that bulldog clip for now. Okay, I think that's the little journal pieces done, so I'll put that one away, and I can tell you about these couple of little freebies I've made. Oh no, I've got one more thing. I've got this the large bag. This guy here, so it just folds up like so. But what I do like to do is use some of those fancy scissors. Now I can put that away. My mini pinking scissors, and I like to give them a little pink along this bottom edge here. You know, like when you buy a paper bag and it looks like it's been cut by the machine with little pinking edges, and also down this side here. So I'm just going to cut a tiny weeny little bit off there. Has to be small, because otherwise there'll be no room for sticking it down. Okay. There's something quite satisfying about cutting things with these scissors, especially when they're sharp. Okay, so then I'm going to put some glue down here. Should I have inked that? Maybe I'll just... I don't know if it'll make any difference. I'll just put a little bit there. Okay. And then put that one on there. Put this one along the bottom. I'll ink it. Just a second. Okay. And then put some glue on here. Bottom of our bag, fold that up. Good press. Get the glue everywhere. It'll be fine. Okay, and then I'm going to use my little mini pinchers and cut along the top like you'd get for a paper bag. I have this real desire to screw the bag up a little bit. I don't know. Okay. So then that's like the top of our bag. I put a little bit of ink along the edges where I've folded. You know how like paper bags get crinkly really easily because they're quite thin paper? I really, really want to screw it up. And then unscrew it. Should I? It's just a piece of paper, right? Okay, so if this doesn't work, I don't recommend screwing it up. But I just thought it would look cool if it wasn't so perfect. This is actually quite a thick copy of paper. I think it's 120 GSM. So, there you go. A nice little screw look to you now. Oh, I like that. See if I can open it. There we go. Now I like it. Now it looks like a paper bag. Just needed screwing up. Okay, so that's going in a pocket. So everything's looking very brown at the moment, but when we do a little bit of decoration, it'll look a bit different. We'll just pop that in here for now. I don't believe that anything's going to stay where I put it, but it just gives me a bit of an idea about how thick our little file's getting. Folio. Pretty good. Okay, then I have some... Okay, so now I'm moving on to a couple of little freebies. I'm going to put these in the Facebook group, Bella Creative Divas. It'll be a pinned post. So the first one is going to be the simple envelope. So the simple envelope just looks like a simple envelope. This is it here. And it also will have the mat, so if you wanted to cut it out of cardstock or something else and mat it with your scrapbook paper, you can easily do that. I am not going to, so I've just cut it out of my paper, and all we do is fold it up and glue it together. Ta-da! And there you go. Now, mine's a tiny weeny bit short, you might be able to see there. I fixed it for the one that's going in the Facebook group. So don't worry about that. All I'm going to do is put a little slither of something different on paper on there to decorate it. Like, you know, like, what have we got here? You know the little strip that you get on the edge of your scrapbook paper? I might just attach a little bit along there for a bit of flair, and then it'll look like that. That could be cool. So that's possible. So that's one thing. And of course, because this is an SVG, it means you can make this any size you like. Okay, so this is the biggest I can make mine and cut it out of an A4 sheet of paper. So let's just put that one together. I'll just, should I do this bit now? What do you think? I think so. So... I need to put a sliver of glue along here. So of course you don't need to do this because you won't have the slightly shortened version of the envelope. Oh, hang on. Yep, it needs to be this way. I'll just stick that along there like that. Look, it's not very straight. That's okay. And then we'll just trim. I'm just going to trim that straight. I don't know how I'm going to trim it. I'm just going to trim it. Right, so maybe I can round that. I'm not sure. No, I can't get it in there. Okay, that's fine. Let's put a bit of ink on there. Okay, and then I can glue this thing down. So I'm just put some glue along here. Simple little envelope. You can make it out of any colour paper you want or scrapbook paper you want. What size do you want? There we go. It's my little envelope. It's obviously going to need a little bit of embellishing. But I have fixed up that little issue that I had on mine that you won't have on yours. Okay, so that's going to go in here somewhere. It's going to need a little bit of TLC, bit of embellishing, making it look pretty. We'll sort that out later. And then the last little freebie I've got is these guys here. And these are called framed inserts. And these are just something else that you can just pop in your album or in your journal, anything you like really. So there are four of them. They're all in one file, and I've just staggered them in the file like this, and each one is just a slightly different color blue so you can tell the difference. And then I've just included one pink mat, and this that mat will fit any size. Okay, so there's four different ones, so let's have a look at those. And of course you do need to know how to change the lines on here from cut lines to score lines and attach them to that piece. Otherwise, if you don't do that, your machine will just trim off all of the edges for you, and you don't want it to do that. So I'll pop this one in the Facebook group as well. I think this might be a little handy addition. We'll see. Okay, so we've got four. So we've got one that looks like this. It's just basically a booklet with little tabs all the way around. And then we have one that has an oval here, and then it also has the tabs all the way around. We have this one which has little circles in the corner, otherwise the same. And then this one, which is just the plain frame. So the idea with this, and I probably should have cut some more of these to put on the inside. Okay, so the idea is that you've got options with this. So you would turn this, we'll just do one, right? So that you know, because I've only cut one mat out. So we would put this inside here and glue it down. And we could also do one on the back. But we won't now, because I didn't cut one out, did I? This is a little bit of paper that, you know, a little scrappy bit. So I'm just going to pop that on there. And then we turn this little guy over, and we can either have this as a top opening little insert, so you can put an insert in here, you know, it's this little frame. And if you wanted to make it top loading, then you would cut this top tab off and not seal that up, because that's where your insert's going. But you would fold these two little tabs over and glue those down like that. And this one, and then your insert would be, I'm just showing you. Then your insert would be at the top here, so we trim this top tab off, and you would insert your whatever it is you wanted to insert in here. You could also cut this out of vellum, or I'm pretty sure I must stuck that down, because a little bit of this, let's say, and then it will be like a little bit of vellum or something like that. So then you could see through it, and you could slide it in there. Okay, so have I made sense, or is this 4:30 a.m. talking going on here? Have I finished my tea? Yeah, might be time for more tea. Anyway, I think you get the idea, right? All right, guys, I'm either going to go to bed and try and get some more sleep, or I'm going to have a cup of coffee. I'm not sure which, but hopefully I'll see you soon with a little flip through of my little completed folio. Thanks very much for bearing with me, because I'm obviously not very with it. And I'll see you guys again soon. Bye for now.